linggo ng Rene Catriona Gray bilang bagong Miss Universe. At dito sa New York, kung saan nakabase ang Miss U, sunod-sunod ang kanyang mga media guesting at interview. At sa mga pagkakataong pwede, lagi niyang suot ang mga may Filipiniana accent. Katulad nung ating siya'y nakapanayam.
Nice to see you again. Thank you for this interview. First of all, Catriona, thank you very much para sa interview na ito.
It's so nice to be able to sit down with you because I know last time that we saw each other, we were like saving it for this date.
Okay. How are you as a Miss Universe? Ano ang sa tingin mo ay kahulugan ng iyong corona at ng iyong title? At ano ang iyong paninindigan bilang Miss Universe? What do you stand for as Miss Universe?
I want to be a spokesperson, but now I'm so blessed to be given such a wider and larger audience. Because being an advocate, being a spokesperson has really been the core of being a Miss Philippines. Mm-hmm. And in my life for the last 3 years. Mm-hmm. So being able to continue to do what I love, but to be able to reach more people, that's what a Miss Universe is for me, and that's what this year will represent.
May mga Australian na tingin nila nanalo daw si Miss Queensland o si Miss Australia. There's actually this one newspaper na nagsabi nanalo si Miss Queensland or Miss Australia.
Yes, I saw.
Anong reaction mo doon?
I think they're just excited. Mm-hmm. And I know a lot of people got very offended, but I think everyone's spirits are very high. It's a holiday season, and you know, in a way, my childhood was being an Australian. Mm-hmm. I was born and grew up there, so I don't think it's the worst thing. The way that they did it, medyo ano, with the crossing out, I don't really agree with that. But I think they do have a right to be proud and excited and a part of the celebration. I don't want to withhold that from them.
Mm-hmm. Pero Miss Philippines ka eh.
Exactly.
Diba?
No, but what I'm saying is like the way that they did it wasn't right.
Yes.
But why not let them be a part of the celebration?
Sa Q&A, as romanticizing poverty daw. Do you care to comment about that?
I was not romanticizing poverty. I'm not saying that it's beautiful there. Mm-hmm. So if you look at my answer in the context of looking at the first sentence, it does not romanticize poverty because I start from that point. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there is nothing beautiful about poverty, but in the people that you talk to, the teachers that I've met, the children who I've heard their stories of, and the families that I've heard their stories of, there is something beautiful about their spirit, their will, their determination, and that's what I was referring to.
Tona, sorry to ask about this, but how are you and Clint?
I'd rather not comment on my private life. Yeah, you know, because I've been flung into this world arena overnight, and there's very little that I can keep for myself, and that's something I want to keep for myself.
That's okay. I understand. You've been wearing a lot of local touches sa yung mga damit dito sa
New York. Yes, I actually have one today. I feel like this is Ifugao fabric. Mm-hmm. And
yeah, it just makes me proud. I do love our fabrics, our textiles, our, you know, symbolism and our culture. And so many people have garnered interest just from what I'm wearing.
Ah, talaga?
Yeah, and I mean, it's a different approach to sharing our culture or our what we have to offer through outfits. Some people might think, oh, it's just fashion, but it opens up the conversation. Oh, I didn't know that Philippines has that kind of fabric. I didn't know that they have that to offer. And I love seeing comments like that.
Kamusta naman? You got here January
2.
Yeah. So it's been a week almost.
Yeah, I think I'm on my 5th day. What is it today? The 8th?
Yeah, the 8th.
Yeah,
so
okay.
Not even a week.
6 days. And I've even spent my birthday here. Uh-huh. It's just been amazing. The Miss Universe organization has made the adjustment feel very smooth. They've really looked after me. I moved into my apartment. And it's a beautiful location. I can look out the window and see Central Park. Because it's just, you know, this is what everyone dreams of. As a Miss Universe participant, this is the dream that 94 of us are grasping for. Mm-hmm. And I feel so grateful that I'm able to realize it and that I'm here in New York City.
Wow. Congratulations.
Thank
again.
You.
Catriona, hinga naman kita ng message sa ating mga kababayan, lalo na yung mga follower mo sa Instagram. You're 4 million now.
Grabe,
at yung mga fans mo rin.
millions.
Yeah, like 3 million in what, a matter of weeks. It's really overwhelming. But maraming salamat po sa lahat ng supporters that I have from the Philippines, from other countries. You guys have made this journey such a fulfilling one. You are the reason that I stepped through the doors of Bini Bini on day one. And to see you carry me through this journey every step of the way, I couldn't have done it without you. Mahal ko kayo sobra sobra. Thank you so much.
So what's in store for Catriona Gray as the new Miss Universe? Yan ang susunod pa nating aabangan. Mula po rito sa New York, ako si Jessica Soho, GMA News.